took 15 years ago, my healthy daughter, Sarah, suddenly died in the middle of the night. Went back to work the next week, and the company I worked for fired me. I was lost. I figured I had these skills as a business person. Why not go as a volunteer to Africa? In a way, trying to give meaning to my daughter's death. According to the World Health Organization, there's about 600 million people who are hearing impaired. Two-thirds of them live in developing countries. Yet only 12% of hearing aids go to these countries. The problem with hearing aids is not only the cost of a hearing aid, but the price and accessibility of a hearing aid battery. Battery costs about a dollar and lasts about a week. One of the common features in developing countries is the sun is free. Why not use that energy to recharge a battery? So what we did is, with our workers who are deaf, we designed the first rechargeable hearing aid battery that, you know, costs the same as a regular battery, but lasts 2 to 3 years. We can make a hearing aid and sell it at a profit for under $100. And the average hearing aid in the United States, for example, is anywhere from $2,000 to $6,000. And they're buying from the same sources I do. You know, Carl Jung, the great philosopher, once said, you want people to see their shadow and then realize the light is coming from them. And that's, you know, what I do with our workers who are deaf around the world. Our project's all about opportunity, about seeing your own shadow.